and Sekiro Shadows Die Twice at the start of the game. Let's get max stats and make everyone, including the bosses, a complete joke. What's up, guys? Jay Sharp here with GHS, bringing you more game hacking shenanigans using Cheat Engine, which you can download at cheatengine.org. Just pay attention to the install, because Cheat Engine comes coupled with adware to help keep it free. But by paying attention, you can easily decline it to get a nice clean install of the program. And if you feel you need more help with this, click the link at the top or in the description below. And the next step is just to fire up Cheat Engine and Sekiro, which I loaded in windowed mode to make it easier to work with both it and Cheat Engine at the same time. And then just load a save. And once everything's completely loaded, first attach Cheat Engine to the game by clicking the computer icon at the top, and then double-clicking Sekiro in this process list. And make sure you see the right process name at the top of Cheat Engine before you continue. Alright, the first thing we'll be manipulating is our money or coin value, because it's the easiest to find. You'll need some coins to start with, so once you have some, type the coin value into this scan box and click First Scan, or hit Enter on your keyboard. Now we just need to make a change to the coin value, which I'll do by jumping off this cliff, which will kill me and cut my coin value in half. Now, just type the new coin value into the scan box and click Next Scan or hit Enter again. So, to the left, we now have a few rows of some wacky numbers, and the only ones we're interested in are the values here, one of which is the value of our coins. Let's figure out which one it is by selecting them all, by clicking one on the end, then shift-clicking this one and adding them all to the address list by clicking this little red arrow. Now, down here, I'll just start changing the values by double-clicking each number and then typing in a new one, and I'll exit and re-enter the inventory screen to refresh the coin value each time I do that, and I'll repeat these steps until I see the coin value in the game change to match what's in Cheat Engine. And there we go! Looks like this is the one that caused the change. So, I'll delete the other entries by selecting them and hitting the delete key on my keyboard. And I think I'll give myself a ton of coins, because why not? Now, we're just four more value hacks away from becoming awesome. First up is XP, and while we could scan for its value like we just did with coins, I've done all the legwork for you to make this even easier. Right-click on the coin row and then click Copy. Then beneath it, right-click and choose Paste, and then click Paste in this pop-up window. And I'll do this three more times, but I'll hit Ctrl-V and then Enter each time until I have a total of five rows here. Now, in the second row, under the column titled Address, double-click. This opens a new window with this crazy number. Click just behind it, then type plus E4, then click OK or the Enter key. And now the value matches my current XP. Change the value to any number you want at or below 2 billion. Then go take out a bad guy and enjoy super fast leveling. And if this isn't high enough for you, change the value again and go take out another bad guy, and repeat this until you're at the level you want. Again, limit yourself to 2 billion XP at a time or this won't work. Next, let's work on vitality. For this to work, you need at least one prayer bead to unlock the ability to increase your stats, which I've gotten by taking out this guy. Then, double-click under the address column of the third row, and go to the end of this absurd number and type plus 7A1C, and now we've tapped into the quantity of our prayer beads, which is what allows you to increase your vitality. Then, change the value to whatever you want, then head to an idol and let's start the increase. And a quick tip to make this even faster. Click the box for the speed hack in Cheat Engine and slide the scroll bar up a bit to speed up your game. And next, we'll hit up our gourd seeds to give us more healing gourd uses. Double-click the address column's fourth row and behind this insane number, type plus 7A0C, then change the value to whatever you want. And go talk to this lady over here to get your healing gourd upgrade. And to complete this, we need to beef up our attack. Double-click in the address column of the bottom row, and behind this ridiculous number, type plus 7A2C, and after, I'll change my value to 5. But I got a slight problem. I don't have any memories. Changing the value didn't seem to give me any. So, two options here. You can either go to this guy, and take him out to get the memory we need, or if you're not scared to go a little bit deeper in a Cheat Engine, we can add the memory to inventory ourselves and save a lot of time. Right-click anywhere in the bottom row and click Browse this memory region. And in the viewer here, ignore the top half because we don't need it. Then right-click any number down here, click Display Type and choose 4-byte decimal, which will make these numbers a lot easier to understand. And now you can see in the top left is the 5 I typed in, which is the quantity of our memories. And click the up arrow on the scroll bar to bring up the next line. Now it's time to type in a few more numbers. I'll bring them up on the screen here in Notepad. And by the way, these numbers plus the ones before will be in the video description. And working backwards, I'll copy-paste the numbers in Notepad to the ones in the viewer. Just double-click each of the numbers in the viewer, and then type or paste the ones in the Notepad. And after you're done, just double check and make sure all the numbers match up exactly. And then we can close Notepad and the viewer. And now here in inventory, I have the battle memory. And back at an idle, we can start boosting our attack. And even though it's showing I have no memories, I can still keep increasing attack. And increasing, and increasing, and increasing some more until I get to the max. And with these stats, we're now officially OP. And if you want to learn more about how to use Cheat Engine and game the way you want to, check out the Game Hacking 100 series, linked to the top right and in the description below. And if you have any questions, be sure to drop them in the comments below and I'll be happy to answer. Thanks for watching, see you next time.